That T wine girl, don't need to read your mind, I can see the signs, girl.
Okay, hey y'all. Today is a new day. It's the next day. It's Friday, February 22nd. I keep saying it's Friday and it's not. It's Thursday. Today is Thursday. February 22nd. Now, as y'all saw yesterday, we got our floors put down. We got our floors started. They're like maybe 80% down as far as the floor, dining room, and living room. Now we still got the stairs to do, but as far as like the dining room and living room. But yeah, I did not get up at 8 o'clock this morning like I said I would. I mean, not at 8 o'clock. I did not get up at 6:30 like I said I would. I didn't even get up at 7:30. I didn't get up until after 8 o'clock. I don't know why I was so tired this morning, but I was. I was like out of it tired. As you can hear and see, it's raining, so that might have something to do with it. But, and then I was moving that stuff yesterday. That was a lot. It didn't probably seem like a lot, but with all the stuff that was down there, once you see what all is not there, you realize like that really was a lot. So I think between doing that and then from there I had to cook dinner and clean up and all that other stuff, I think from there plus the rain this morning is why I was like not doing it. I can't get up this early. So anyway, I got up, obviously, breakfast, lunch, got everybody out the house, got Honey off, he was running behind this morning, got the kids off, we was running behind this morning, everybody was just running behind. He was like, I was tired, so it's just something in the air. So I got up, once I got them done, got them all dropped off and stuff, well not Honey, he drove himself, but once I got the kids dropped off, I came out here to get my eyebrows and stuff done. And they don't open until 11. I wanted to be ready so that I could leave the house and then not have to come back until I was done, because once I get in the house, I ain't gonna really feel like leaving back out until I actually like have to leave back out. So I'm like, okay, let me just get dressed and go now. When I drop them off, I just go straight out there, forgetting that they don't open till 11, but they've always opened at 11. So like I said, I just forgot. But I am, while I'm out here, I'm about to run down the street and put some money down on our couch, because I got our couch already. Well, I'm holding it, should I say. I put some money down on our couch already. I picked it out. I have to go down there and put some more money on there. I came out here a couple weeks ago before my mother went out of town to put some money on there, but the price seemed wrong to me and I was like, I don't think that's what I agreed to pay for this couch. So I went home, looked at my receipt. Of course I forgot it today, but they was right, so it don't even matter. So I'm gonna put some more money on it. I said I was just gonna keep putting money on it until we was ready. Like, it's no point in paying it off and just asking them to hold it when I could just keep paying on it, you know. So while I'm out here, I'm gonna do that. It was something else I wanted to do while I was out here. I can't think of what it was. It was something else while I was out this way, because I'm not by my house at all. Like, I'm probably like 30 minutes, not 30, not quite 30, maybe 20 minutes away from my house. So I was gonna do a couple things while I was out this way, but I don't remember what. I was gonna get my eyebrows and stuff done. I was gonna put some money on the couch. I'm trying to decide, do I wanna go to Starbucks or not? Y'all know me. But I do have my protein shake, so that when I, in about 30 minutes, I'll drink it. Of course, nobody was, I was in this parking spot by myself. Not in the parking lot, but just in this little area. I was in this area by myself. Nobody was right here. And as soon as I pull up the camera, now people want to pull up and park right next to me. Y'all, my feelings just got hurt so bad. My feelings just got hurt so bad. So I went in to put some money on my couch, right? For whatever reason, today I decided to try to find out, like, make sure it's not too big. Well, come to find out, the couch is not just too big, it's entirely too big. So we was trying to figure out what couch to get, but I got stuck on the couch that I want. Like, I want that couch, that's the couch I want. So nothing else in there was appealing to me. Like, I didn't want none of it. So mind y'all, I got to the eyebrow spot at like 10:30. Remember I said they open in 30 minutes, right? And I was like, it's not gonna take me 30 minutes. Well, now it's 12:30. It took me 2 hours in there, literally, because I'm trying to figure out what I want. Because what I want, I can't get. So I ended up putting some money on the couch anyway, because I mean, putting some more money on there, just because there's always the possibility of, like, taking pieces out and stuff like that. It's just a matter of, is it gonna look right? So I didn't put a lot on there, but I did put some to show that I'm still paying on it, just in case we still get it, just take out some of the pieces, because it's a section. So I feel like I'm screaming because the rain is hitting the car so heavy. But since it's a sectional, you can take out pieces or whatever. So I still put money on there just in case we still end up getting it. We just got to get less pieces or, you know, whatever. So, but it's another furniture store. It's actually two other furniture stores right next door that I never even looked in. So I'm about to run in here and see if I potentially find something that I really like and will fit my space. And then I'm not sure what happens with the money over at the other furniture store. I don't know if I lose that money because I'm not getting it, or if I have to use it, it goes into a credit. I'm not sure. That's why I try not to put a whole lot of money on it today, just because I think I only put like $200 on it the first time, and then I just put $100 on it. So if I lose $300 or it has to go to a credit, I can get like a nightstand or an end table or something if I need to. But I'm out to run in here, y'all. I have not ate yet. That's why I'm drinking this. And I'm trying to drink this so that I can decide what I want. Like, if that makes sense. Because trying to decide what I want to eat while I'm currently hungry as hell just never works out for me. So I'm drinking this so that I can make a decision. And also, I'm by the mall, so I was thinking about running in there and getting something to eat. Part of me want Chick-fil-A. The other part of me want Chinese, which is next door at the mall. This particular mall don't have Chick-fil-A no more, so. And I don't even know where. It's a Chick-fil-A, like, that I technically have to pass to go home. But I don't know. I can't decide. So let me run in here, see if they have anything worth my time. I need to know why they don't make small sections. Like, not the two sectionals or the three sectionals like on the couch. I mean the ones that curve. Because I'm so tired of the standard sofa love seat look. That's all I've had all my life. And I'm tired of it. Which is why I'm trying to find the kind of couch that I am trying to find. But it's like, no matter what I do, it's just not working out, or it's gonna be too small, and I don't want it to be super small. I want some elbow room, you know what I'm saying? I don't know. Anyway, so let me go in here. I may or may not pick y'all up in this store. If they got something that I'm looking at, I will. I didn't pick y'all up in the last store because I was frustrated. And I was so irritated. I couldn't do nothing but laugh. Literally, when people would walk past and be like, are you okay? Are you being helped? I'm being helped, but no, I'm not okay. You finding everything? No, I'm not. You need some help? Yes, I need somebody to make this couch fit in my house. So, yeah. that's where I'm at. Hopefully this experience is it at least a little better. So we'll see.
Hey y'all, and welcome back to another day. Yesterday I was so frustrated and so over it and so aggravated and agitated. I was all over the place yesterday, so I never even picked the camera back up. I think the last place I left off was, where did I leave off? Getting ready to go into the other furniture store. They didn't have nothing I liked, nothing I wanted, nothing I could even work with. So the problem was the area that the couch is going in is smaller than it looks to me. So based off the numbers, I was stressing out because the couch that I was getting is way too big. And every, like, because it's a sectional and you can buy this piece, don't buy that piece, whatever the case is, in order to make it look right, I needed at least four pieces, like four chairs in the console. So I needed at least the five pieces total, and it was still gonna be too big. For it to look right, that's what I need. So once I saw, like, okay, even that's gonna be too big, that's when I got frustrated. And so I went looking for something else, and they didn't have nothing else. Nothing else that I wanted, at least. Nothing else that I wanted. Nothing else that was even remotely close, because either the fabric was off, the color was off, the comfort was off. Something was off about everything. And it very well could have been that I want what I want now. And that's not what I want. Like, it could have been that. But for the most part, I feel like it was just because that couch is perfect. And so that's what I wanted. And so once it was like, that's not working out, y'all, I was over it. I think I stopped at Popeye's. I got me and my aunt some chicken, and I took her chicken, and I came home, and I was over it. Then I got a letter in the mail from my kids' school. I had to go up to the school and handle that, because that, y'all, it was just so, it was BS, and it really, like, threw me off. So on top of already being frustrated about the couch, now I come home to see this, and it's like, really? So I had to go handle that. Came home for like 10 minutes. What felt like 10 minutes. It was probably more like 30 minutes, but still. Came home for like what felt like 10 minutes. My friend had called me and asked me to look into a Disney cruise for her. So I did that. I wasn't even done doing that, and it was time to go get the kids. Then when I came home, I didn't feel like cooking. I didn't feel like doing nothing. So I was just like, you know what? Honey's coming home today. He's not staying for overtime. I'm going to see if he can bring home dinner. The boys wanted pizza, so they had pizza. And then I went to bed. Like, I'm over today. Today I woke up, though. Once again, I didn't get up at 6:30. I didn't even get up at 7. But I did get up at 7:45. I did do that. So I'm making my way back up. Anywho, I checked the measurements. Because when I text our contractor to find out would this couch be too big for the space, I told him that I thought he said that the walls were 7.5 and 8.5. But actually, when I checked the wall, they're not 7.5 and 8.5. I actually have 5 more inches on each side than I thought I had. So, revelation, just right before I came on, I can get my couch. I can get my couch. Because the last thing that me and the lady at the store came up with, I would have needed 4 more inches in order to get it to where it was like, okay, this is good. Like, it's not exactly what you wanted, but it's good. It could work. All I needed was 4 more inches, and I didn't think I had it, and I just found out I have it. I have 5 extra inches on both sides, actually. Ooh! Yeah. Y'all understand how happy that actually makes me, because I might actually be able to get, I can't get the whole couch. Like, I still have to get pieces. But I can definitely get more pieces than I thought I could. And now I'm very, 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 very happy. So, it's actually way better out today. It's sunny out today. It makes me want to get up and go. Versus yesterday, it was all rainy. And that was another reason I was tired, because it was just raining all day long. And today is supposed to be nicer. But I actually have stuff to do today inside the house, which means I'm probably not going to work today. But I did get up and get dressed because I have work to do. Not that anybody's going to see me because I work from home. But I feel like when I'm in my pajamas and lounging around, I get more distracted by home stuff. Like, next thing you know, I get to chilling, I'm watching TV. I might even try to do my nails. I might clean up my house, do my laundry. Like, I just get caught up in home stuff because I'm comfortable and I'm at home. But when I actually get dressed, like I have to go to work, like somebody's going to see me on this camera, I tend to be a little bit more productive on my work stuff. I don't know if it's just a mental thing. I don't know if that's everybody's like that or if it's just me. But I do. I tend to be a little bit more productive when I actually get dressed as if I'm going to work. Hey y'all, so I have literally been at this computer all day. Like, from the last time I picked y'all up to now, I've gotten up to go grab something to eat and to go get the kids from school. That's it. It's currently almost 6 o'clock and I have been working on a trick for my client. It's not hard. I'm gonna show y'all one day like how I do my proposals so that y'all can see. Like, it's not hard. I just be trying to do my big one for my clients, you know? And then also, it's a lot of logistics that's going into this particular trip. So there's that.
Usually I don't post. Usually I don't post, but I want the world to know. Time to pull the drop tops out. Summer nights, it's a vibe, yeah. We've been keeping it in the house. Netflix and chilling, I GDMing, yeah. Didn't wanna share my love till I found someone I'm sure of. Young and untamed, I've been out of range, keeping it low, but I wanna be bold with it. Don't care who we told about it. Wow, baby, got a hold on it. Let love unfold tonight, they'll be calling us gold. No lies, so fair with it. People let them stare at it. Now I'm prepared. Oh, yeah. Instead of love out loud, since we ain't going nowhere. So tonight. But I want the world to know. I'm a good catch, but I never let them catch me. No, I never let them claim me. Wild thing try to tame me. But you got my mood on sunshine. Let's take a trip. Souls on big smiles. Let's get this lick. Stars are in line. I'm posted. So lay with me in the moonlight. I wanna be bold with it. Calling us gold. No lies, so fair with it. We can let them stare at it. Now I'm prepared. Oh, yeah. Instead of love out loud, since we ain't going nowhere. So tonight.
Good morning and welcome back to another video. Today is Monday, February 26th, and I'm so proud of myself. I did get up at 6:30 this morning. I got up at 6:30. No, I didn't work out. No, I didn't stretch. No, I didn't do none of that, but I did go ahead and take my shower, got myself ready. Literally, all I gotta do is throw my clothes on. Like, I got up, took my shower, brushed my teeth, washed my face, did everything, and then I came down and cooked breakfast, packed everybody's lunch, and literally honey just got out the door, and now I'm about to get the boys out the door. Today I have to, oh, and I made my coffee this morning. I made decaf because I got some running to do today. So y'all know, again, people who know, who follow, who actually watch my vlogs outside of just travel, y'all know my addiction to Starbucks is like on another level. So because I got some running to do today, I know I'm gonna stop at Starbucks. So in order to combat the fact that I had coffee this morning, I decided to do decaf. Normally, if I drink regular coffee, I won't do Starbucks, because even though I get a refresher with water, I think the acai stuff still got caffeine in it. And too much caffeine for me is not good. It's just not good. So, in order to have my morning coffee and still get my Starbucks, I decided to do decaf. If I wasn't going anywhere, like if I was gonna drop the boys off and literally come right back home, I might've did regular coffee instead of decaf, just because I like coffee. I like coffee, and if I'm not gonna have my refresher, then I could have the caffeine from the coffee. So anyway, today the guys are coming back to finish the floor. They coming back to finish the floor today, and I'm so excited. But I have to go get the quarter round, the T-molder, and the baseboards. I was supposed to do it this weekend, but Saturday I was just in one of my moods, I guess. I was tired. I literally, when I say I slept all day on Saturday, that is like literally, I literally slept all day on Saturday. Yesterday I didn't sleep all day, but I was still in like a mood, and so I didn't end up going. I was gonna go last night when honey got home, because I wanted to make sure that I didn't have the kids with me so that I could let my seats down. But that didn't happen, so I have to go do it today. And I'm going to do it this morning because they should be here sometime this afternoon. And I don't want to have to go get it. I don't want to have them waiting and all that other stuff. If they can finish it today, I want them to finish it today. And not have to be waiting on me if they don't have to. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm going to do that. Y'all know me. I be saying I'm going to take y'all with me. And then, it don't happen because I'm still trying to get used to vlogging in public. And I don't like vlogging on my phone. I don't know if I told y'all that. I think I did tell y'all that. It's not that I hate vlogging on my phone. Vlogging on my phone is fine. I hate editing videos that came off my phone. If that makes sense. That it just, like, I have an iPhone and I don't have an Apple computer. So it just, you gotta go through too much when you don't have the same brand all across the board. Like, I got a Windows computer and, or a laptop. And when I say, or a, what is it? It's an MSI, whatever that is. It's an MSI, but it's not Apple. And y'all know when y'all not doing Apple to stop it. When you're not doing Apple to Apple, it's difficult. And so I hate it. So I may take y'all with me, but then again, don't be surprised if I don't. But anyway, so that's on my agenda for this morning, which is part of why I went on and got ready. If I can, I'm gonna try to squeeze in some workout time today. I feel great. The fact that I got up at 6:30 this morning and it's 8:42 and everybody has had breakfast, lunches are packed, honey is gone, the boys are either still eating or getting ready for school. I'm not sure. I haven't been back upstairs yet. They haven't brought their plates down yet. Here they come. Here they come. So they about to start getting ready and it's not even 9 o'clock yet. I feel amazing. So I'm about to clean up this stuff because I'm not eating yet. I'm gonna probably eat when I come back. I'm not hungry and I'm trying to not eat like when I first wake up. I try to stop eating at a certain time and then don't eat until a certain time. And I actually
it's not that good, but it's a little good. Only if it didn't have like those vegetables in it.
So you about to waste all that?
No, I can try it.
I think you should try it again. Mm-hmm. I would just suggest don't waste all of it. Even if you don't eat all of it, don't waste all of it. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Especially since I didn't give you a lot. Mm-hmm. Okay. Mm-hmm. But I won't make that one no more. And tell your brother, don't even show me his if his look like yours. Huh? Yours look like his? Uh-huh. Oh, no. Eat some of it. Don't waste all of it. I didn't give you that much, but don't waste all of it. This morning, I cooked, but I took the easy route. Generally speaking, I try to do like homemade stuff, toast, fruit. Sometimes I do take the easy route and do regular waffles. Not regular waffles, but like the Eggo waffles. My thing is I try to make morning time as easy as possible just because it's like the busiest time. You know what I'm saying? I try to make that as easy as possible so that I can get everything that I need to get done and get everybody out the door. So I generally do like toast and fruit, or I'll do toast, a breakfast meat like bacon or sausage and fruit, or I'll do waffles, a breakfast meat and fruit. I try to now make sure that they start their day with some sort of fruit. I also had got into juicing for a minute where I would juice fruit and vegetables and stuff, and it was like, okay, well, at least at a minimum you got this. And we really like the spinach, apple and cucumber juice, but we don't have a juicer right now. And going through trying to juice with our blender, because we got a really, really good blender, and I could do it with the blender, but it would just take entirely too long and it just way too much. I'd rather just wait till we get another juicer. So until then, I got Bloom and it's okay. It's not that good. Nobody really likes it, but like, I don't even really like it, but it's better than nothing. And then generally speaking, I mix up whichever fruit. I just try to make sure that they have a fruit in the morning along with whatever else they like. Like, they really like meat, so a breakfast without bacon or sausage to them is like, but they do it sometimes because I don't believe that you have to have meat every single morning. But anyway, let's go, because I will sit here and talk to y'all until I'm late. So, about to get ready, head to Home Depot, come back home, and I'll see y'all in a minute.
So before I go up, I wanted y'all to see how far we got with the floor. I think the last time I showed y'all, the whole dining room wasn't done. I think like this strip right here still wasn't done. So they had to bring everything from the living room to the dining room so that they could work on the dining room. I mean, on the living room. So now we up to the stairs. We wasn't up to the stairs last time I showed y'all, I don't think. And now, that's all they got left to do. And then the living room and dining room will be done. I don't remember if I told them that the floor was supposed to come out here too. I'm not sure. I thought I did, but from where they stopped, I'm assuming that I must not have told them yet. But it's okay because it'll get done. Even if it don't get done right now, it'll be done. But yeah, so I have to go get the baseboards and the T-molding, which I believe is the strip that goes like right there. And then again in the kitchen, it's gonna go right there, I believe. And the quarter round to go on the stairs and the stair noses. So I gotta go get that stuff today from Home Depot. And then by the time y'all see this again, at a minimum, this stuff should be done. The stairs might not be done. They might not even be started, but they should. This all in here should be done by the next time y'all see this. And I am so excited. Like this, because this is the kitchen floor that we're going with, like this is the new kitchen floor. They're gonna finish this off today and connect it so that it's not like that no more. He had an idea of what to do right here, but I forgot what he said, and I'm not sure if he's gonna get to that today or not. And oh my God, we are almost there. We're not almost done, but I could definitely see the light at the end of the tunnel. And I gotta take this piece with me so that they can match the T-molding and the, what do you call it, quarter round to it. And then I gotta take a picture of the baseboard so that they can see what kind of baseboard I need. So yeah, I got stuff to do. So let me get to it and I will see y'all later. Instead of love out loud, since we ain't going on so tonight.
For the guy that worked here that I asked, he was lazy, and then another guy, he just came and helped me. He don't even work here, but he came and helped me. But to be honest, I still don't know what I'm looking for. I don't know what to get. Yeah, because I don't know what we already have. Like, I took a picture of it, but honestly, I don't think that that's gonna actually help. So, yeah, that's where we at. Like, look at this. How am I supposed to know what to get when I got all these options? I am not a girly that knows her way around a store like this. And like I said, the guy who I actually worked here, he was lazy as hell. He actually sent me to the wrong damn aisle. So yeah.
So let me try to figure it out again, because like I said, I don't know. It was a guy who came and helped me, but there's only so much he can help me because I don't know what I'm looking for real. So there's only really so much he could even help me with. And the guy that worked here didn't even want to get out of his chair. So. So, I can tell y'all what I won't ever be doing again, and that's coming to a hardware store by myself. Not only do I not know for real what I'm supposed to be getting, but there's so many people here who act like they don't want to help you. Or they answer you as if you're supposed to know. Like, that's irritating. You work here, not me. I'm getting more help from customers than I am from the people that actually work here. And one thing y'all know about me, customer service is very important to me. It's very important to me. I really can't stand when I go somewhere and get piss poor customer service, which I've gotten here so far, except for from the customers. The customers' service is great, but the people who are supposed to be giving it. And so far, I think I'm doing good at matching the stuff. I just don't know if I'm doing good actually getting the stuff. Sorry, I'm also texting the contractor back and forth to try to figure out what I'm supposed to be getting. Y'all, this process has been fucking ridiculous. And the baseboard, I took pictures of it before I left, and guess what? I still don't know which one I'm supposed to get. I don't know. So, and I think I'm supposed to get that too, not this one, because this is for vinyl floor.
Okay, so I am back home, as you can see, and I am about to take these three pieces and lay them on the floor and figure out which one matches better with this floor. The reason why I felt like I wasn't really getting an accurate like I couldn't really determine from at Home Depot is because the piece that I had was like, it was a decent sized piece, but I feel like it's different patterns on different parts of the floor, and I don't know which one matches like the whole picture of the floor better. So I'm about to do this, and I'm gonna eat before I leave, and then I'm gonna go back to Home Depot and get whichever ones match. I'm gonna get all of them. It's 12:23, so I'm hoping within the next hour I could be back out getting the stuff that I need. Like I said, I'm gonna eat first, so not eating nothing major. Whew. Huh. I ain't eating nothing major, so I should be able to finish that in the next 30 minutes. But like I said, oh, and I'm gonna look at the box and see if I can just figure out the color from there. But if not, I'm gonna just lay it all out on the floor and see. Because, like, look. So when I say different patterns, like you see how this is lighter, this is darker, but then that get darker. That got a little bit of some sort of pattern in it. That got some sort of little pattern in it. So I feel like the piece that I had was like all of this, boom, 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 stop. But that piece obviously looks slightly different than this right here. So I feel like I wasn't getting like an accurate like I couldn't tell for real which would have been best. So I had to bring it home. Like I said, I'm gonna make sure that I got my Home Depot card. because what I just paid for those three and how many I actually need, I know that I'm about to be spending a couple hundred dollars. So because I know that, I'm just gonna use my Home Depot card and pay them back at some point, you know? And I don't know if I'm gonna put the clip that I did in the car in there, but y'all, I got my refresher for free today because I had some stars that was getting ready to expire soon, and I had to use them because I don't be playing about my stars. Every time I go, I'm gonna make sure I get my stars, okay? And Joshua will be laughing at me, but it paid off today because I got my drink for free. So, anywho, let me eat. Okay, so I looked at the box to see what color the floor is, and generally speaking, the color is on there somewhere, right? The color is not on this floor at all. I mean, on these boxes at all. Like, when I say at all. So, I took my break so I could eat because I'm hungry. My stomach was literally rumbling. And then, I guess I'm going to just lay the floors down and see which one best match. I don't really know if any of them is going to best match, for real. That's why it would have been much better to have the color on the box, and I could just look for the color. But since I don't know what color I'm looking for, I can't look for the color. This whole process has been one thing after another, after another, after another. And I got until 2 o'clock to figure it out because it's currently 12:43 and they usually come around 2:30, and if I gotta go to a different Home Depot, then I gotta go to that Home Depot, drop that stuff up, and then go back out to another Home Depot. Yeah, and I still have not done my own job today, but this is what I get, because I knew I was supposed to do this weekend, but because I was in a mood, I didn't go nowhere, I didn't feel like it. And now I'm scrambling to do it today. And I knew better. So I gotta put my big girl pants on and get it done. Found it, y'all. This one is perfect, and it's a lighthouse, and I don't think I have lighthouse T-Mobile. Oh, I do. I got lighthouse. I'm sorry, y'all, we got some presentation going on. I got some stuff going on. Oh, this is perfect. So this one right here, feather is going back, and I gotta get the rest lighthouse, because this is perfect. That's gonna look real good. So let me get my stuff together so that I can get ready to get out of here, so that I can go, because it's, sorry, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do.
1:15. And I told y'all I was trying to only be here for an hour and be back out the door by 1:30 so that I can get everything that I need to get and get back and do my stuff. So I'll be back.